Hello again and welcome to another video in our How My Computer Works series. My name is Matt Bauer and this week's video is about transferring your pictures from your digital camera. Now there are several ways you can do this. You can use the software that came with your digital camera to transfer pictures, but that's usually not the most effective way. You can use the built-in Windows Transfer Utility, which I've found to be a simpler option. Or you can use a third-party application like Picasa. Today I'm going to show you how to transfer pictures to your computer using the built-in Windows functionality. Then I'll show you how to import your photos into Picasa and organize them. The first thing you'll want to do is to connect your camera to your computer using the USB cable that came with it. Alternatively, you can insert the memory card from the camera into a card reader if you have one. However, the easiest way is to connect the USB cable to your camera. Depending on your operating system, in this case Windows XP, you should get a pop-up on your screen asking what you want to do with the device you just connected. There should be an option to copy or import using Windows, so go ahead and click that. If you want this option to automatically start the next time you connect the camera, check this box. Now in Windows Vista, the process is a little different. It will import all of your photos at once, but it will not import the duplicates if you have transferred some of the pictures previously. You can add tags right away, but if you click Options, you have a full list of other settings to choose from, as you can see here. It will even auto-rotate your pictures for you if you select this option. When you're done, click OK, then Import. For more information on the photo import process in Vista, click the link in the sidebar. When the Windows XP wizard starts, it will look at all the pictures on the memory card inside the camera. Then just click Next. It will then show you all the pictures on the memory card. Here you can uncheck any photos you do not want to import. You can also rotate the photos to your liking, and when you're all set, click Next. Here you will name the group of pictures and choose a location to save them. The default location is My Pictures, and Windows will automatically create a folder inside My Pictures with the name you specify here. You also have the option of deleting the pictures after they are copied to the computer. I would recommend leaving them on the card until you've backed up your pictures to an additional location, such as an external hard drive or with MCW backup. When you've chosen the location and name, click Next. Windows will begin transferring your photos. When it's done, click Finish. Then Finish again. The folder where you save the pictures will open. You can see the location here. In this case, we saved them to the Summer Vacation 2009 folder inside the My Pictures folder, which of course is inside the My Documents folder. Now that you have your pictures saved to your computer, a great way to organize them is with a program called Picasa from Google. I've been using this software for quite a while, and in my experience, it is very intuitive and user-friendly. There are a lot of features in Picasa, and I may cover them in a future video, but for now, I'll just go through a few of them. Picasa is free, and to get it, just go to picasa.com. Click the download button in the upper right. Open the installer. Click I agree, then install. Now the only boxes you'll need to check here are the first and last ones. The other three can be unchecked. Go ahead and click Finish and Picasa will load up. The first thing it asks you is where you want it to search for your pictures. Well, I know my pictures are in the My Pictures folder, so I'm just going to select the first option here and click Continue. Picasa will find the photos you just transferred and display them. Next, it will ask you if you want to use the Picasa Photo Viewer instead of the built-in Windows Photo Viewer. I prefer the built-in Windows functionality, so I'll go ahead and select this option and click Finish. The main Picasa interface shows a lot of features, such as quick searching, tagging, slideshows, collages, and a lot more. But one of the coolest new features in Picasa is its ability to recognize faces in your pictures. Here you can see it scanning each picture and collecting faces to present to you. You can then tell Picasa who that person is one time. After that, Picasso will make suggestions of other people it thinks might be that same person, and you can then click on the person's name, and it will show you all the pictures in which that person was tagged. You can switch from the face view to the full picture by clicking this button. This facial recognition feature makes finding people in your photos much easier. Picasa has some pretty powerful editing capabilities as well. Just double-click any photo to see them. You can crop, straighten, remove red eye, adjust color and contrast, add text, and even touch up your photos. There are effects you can apply to your photos as well, like sepia, black and white, and glow. And they can all be undone if you don't like the result. Play around with Picasa and see what you can create. Now that I've shown you how to import pictures into your computer and a good way to organize them, we'll take it a step further next week where I'll show you how to create online greeting cards and print them up at a local store such as Walgreens or Walmart. Thanks for watching this week's video. My name is Matt Bauer for My Computer Works, and we'll see you next time.